Yes, I do.
Doctor, what do you think of this concept of dealing with this problem? Dr. Vass is also here at our studios in Washington.
Well, I think that there are two points that have to be made. Number one, with respect to the particular case, I think it's quite understandable that Angie would act as she did. The media have made the case that there is a compelling need to do anything that one can in order to stop the scourge of drugs, which it has now become assumed through conventional wisdom is the cause of every problem in our society. So I don't want anything I say to be construed as a criticism of Angie, who I think is acting very understandably considering the nature of public discourse on drugs. I would say, though, that I think it is not a good idea. It is not a good idea to teach children that their role is to spy on their parents. I think it creates a very bad atmosphere at home, and I don't believe that anybody has made a compelling case that we now have a situation of drug use across America where children need to spy on their parents.
What do you do, doctor, if you're a child and your parent is to you knowingly breaking the law?
Well, let me throw that back with a question. What should a child do if a child perceives that a parent is cheating on their income taxes? Do we want children to investigate their parents with respect to whether or not they're breaking a variety of laws?
What if what the parent does affects the child?
Well, let's
say, for example, what if the parent is drinking and taking the child driving?
Well, then I think you have a different case. That's why I think you have to take it case by case. Let's say, for example, that instead of just evidence that a parent is a user of drugs, that you have evidence, for example, that a mother is using cocaine or using crack.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that presents an imminent medical danger to the unborn. In that kind of case, you'd have a far different, more complicated situation.
Okay, let me get a pause and come back. Our guests are Angie Sigafoos, her father, Roger, and you now live together. You live with your dad.
Yeah.
And Dr. Richard Vass will be including your phone calls. Alan King is still to come. Valerie Harper tomorrow night. Audrey Hepburn on Thursday. This is Larry King live in Washington. Actually, your phone calls are being included as well. Our guests are 11-year-old Angie Sigafoos. Mother's name, by the way, is Sandra Bearden. Her father, Roger Sigafoos, who now has temporary custody of his daughter, Angie. And Dr. Richard Vass of Towson State University. Roger, do you see on what Dr. Vass said the other side of this?
Yeah, sure. I definitely, you know, I've had a lot of thought about it, and it's not a good, you know, situation where, like, as he was saying, you know, for children to actually be spying on their parents and stuff. But there are certain situations where the children are being hurt and neglected very much because of their parents' use of drugs and stuff. And I think this partakes of that situation.
Yeah. Okay, now I've given to understand that Sandra, your mother and your ex-wife, is on the phone. Are you there, Sandra? Okay. I hear you pretty good. You were convicted. You're going to be sentenced on March 19th. Is that correct?
That is correct. We're having an appeal of it.
Okay. How do you feel about what your daughter did?
I feel that a lot of things has been done that she has not got to say or has not been asked so far because she did not turn her mother in. She found something in my apartment. It belonged to my ex-boyfriend, and they found it right where he had it at, in a safe, away from my daughter. And I feel that, sure, she was worried about her mother being hurt, and the only reason that she was is because her father has done a lot of that stuff in front of my child, and she knew it was bad for you. And I have always taught her that you shouldn't do drugs in front of your children, and you shouldn't do drugs, period. And that's why we left her father and came here to live.
Mm-hmm. You did drugs at one time, Roger?
Yes. My wife and I both did.
Okay. In front of your daughter?
Yes,
no,
we both
sir.
Did.
Okay. You did not, Sandra?
No, sir.
Are you saying you didn't?
I have never used drugs.
And how were you convicted?
I was convicted because they had found two empty baggies with residue in a safe in my apartment.
Mm-hmm.
And they used the theory of aiding and abetting to pertain to my conviction.
I see. You're saying then your ex, it's your ex-boyfriend?
Yes, it is.
He was the user and not you?
Yes.
Larry, if I could say one thing at this point, I think this demonstrates one of the problems of having children, in fact, spy on their parents. And that is that children are not sufficiently sophisticated to discern among drug possession, drug use, drug sales. Children are not only insufficiently sophisticated to make these judgments, but they also don't know exactly what effect the drugs have on their parents. Children are taught through the media that drugs are virtually the cause of all untoward behavior, but that isn't necessarily the case. There are all kinds of people who use drugs who do not behave badly. There are all kinds of people who use drugs who behave badly, but would behave badly regardless of their drug use. This is simply a matter far beyond the sophistication of children.
I'm going to ask Angie. I understand what you're saying, Doctor. Do you not believe your mother? Is that it, or is it you're saying your mother is not telling the truth now?
I don't know. Actually, what?
Well, you want her to get help, so obviously you believe she's used drugs. Or else, why want her to get help, right? Yeah?
I'd rather not answer that.
Okay. Sandra, how do you feel about your daughter?
I love my daughter very, very much. I'm sure she feels the same way, and she has made it very clear to me who she wants to live with. You know, even though this has all happened, my daughter still lives in a drug-infested environment, still yet to this day.
Roger, you still use?
No, not at all.
Yes, sir. I think, well, this is not an issue that we want to talk about.
But you also wouldn't know, would you, Sandra?
Excuse me?
You wouldn't know whether...
Yes, I would. Yes, he does.
Okay. Well,
and
Angie,
does
you
too.
Think that your father does?
2 weeks prior to our court case, she found marijuana cigarettes in his cigarette package on top of his refrigerator and made the statement to our attorney that she had also found them there.
Are you happy with your dad?
Yeah.
I mean, would you want to go back to your mom?
Yes, that's what I do want to do.
You want to go back to your mom. Is that okay with you?
Oh, that's, you know, it's up to Angela.
Okay, you don't want your mother to go to jail.
Well...
I mean, you want your mother to get help, you don't want to go to jail, do you?
No.
I'm a little confused. Yeah. You'd like to be back with her and her not used, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
If she does.
Larry, could I ask Angie a question?
Uh-huh.
Angie, let me ask you this. You had reason to believe, rightly or wrongly, you had reason to believe that your mother used drugs. Now, was your mother treating you badly? Was there some behavior that she demonstrated that you thought needed to be changed and was caused by the drugs?
No, not actually.
So in other words, nothing was happening that you thought had to stop and was caused by drugs. You had simply learned that drugs are a terrible thing, your mother was probably using them, and therefore she needed help because she was using them.
Well, I don't understand what you're saying.
Was there any behavior that your mother was doing? Was she mistreating you? Did she hit you? Did she abuse you? Was there any behavior that she was engaged in that you thought had to be stopped and might be caused by drugs?
No.
Did her boyfriend abuse you?
No.
No. So you just saw the drugs and thought this would be damaging to her, right?
Yeah.
Thought she was using, as you would be concerned about your father or anyone you'd see using. Is that your point, Doctor?
Yes, that there really was no evidence here that, that there necessarily was drug use, or B, that if there was, that it was leading to behavior that had to be stopped. The child had learned, as all children now learn, that drug use supersedes all other considerations. If you're using drugs, that equals you need help and need it immediately.
Sandra, did not your son also testify that you used drugs?